There are a lot of myths surrounding keto, so today I'm going to go over the top 5 most common keto myths. Myth number 1, keto is only for epilepsy. First discovered in the late 1800s, keto first gained popularity in the 1920s as a treatment for epileptic children who were not responding to medication. Since that time, there has been published research showing benefits not only for epilepsy and seizures, but also for things like fat loss, muscle growth, improving brain function, improving endurance, and a ton of other therapeutic applications for ailments like type 2 diabetes, cancer, Parkinson's disease, Alzheimer's disease, traumatic brain injury, Crohn's, multiple sclerosis, autism, migraines, PCOS, and even inflammation. Myth number 2, keto is unsustainable. Multiple studies have shown that participants were more likely to stick to a low-carbohydrate diet than a low-fat diet. There are many factors that contribute to this finding, one of which is that a ketogenic diet can actually suppress your appetite. Another factor is the ability to keto-fy familiar dishes by replacing high-carbohydrate ingredients with low-carb alternatives. For example, you can enjoy keto pizza, keto cookies, or even keto pasta. Myth number 3, keto is dangerous. This myth comes out of the confusion between ketosis and ketoacidosis, which are two very different metabolic states. Nutritional ketosis is a normal, healthy metabolic state that has several benefits. In nutritional ketosis, your blood ketone levels are typically between 0.5 and 3 millimoles. Meanwhile, diabetic ketoacidosis typically occurs in uncontrolled type 1 diabetics and occurs when you have extremely high glucose and extremely high ketones. In ketoacidosis, your blood ketone levels are typically 15 millimoles plus. Myth number 4, you can eat as much fat as you want on keto. This myth likely originated from the put butter in your coffee craze in the early 2000s. While putting some fat in your coffee can help keep you full, some people took it to the extreme. Even when eating keto, you should keep your calories and fat in context. Don't shy away from cooking your steak in butter or ghee, or even adding some healthy fats from avocado to your salad. However, you can overdo it and stall your progress if you eat too much fat, especially with things like fat bombs and buttered coffee. Myth number 5. Keto is a high protein diet. This myth likely originated from the Atkins boom, which promoted a higher protein diet. Rather, keto is an adequate or even optimal protein diet. Since the focus is on quality, whole food sources, this way of eating ensures that you are getting sufficient amounts of protein. This differs from a typical bodybuilding style diet full of protein shakes, and instead, focuses on high quality food sources and fattier cuts of meat. In order to do this, you want to aim for about 0.5 to 1 gram of protein per pound of body weight. That'll help you determine how much to eat on a daily basis. I hope you guys enjoyed this series on 5 common keto myths. Let me know in the comments some other common myths you would like to see me address.